I feel paralyzed. Hello guys, what's going on? It's Lemon King here, back for another Minecraft map, and today we're doing some parkour called Smashing Good Parkour, made by Jay Minecrafted. You can check him out on YouTube. Oh, there goes his head. You can check him out on YouTube, and yeah, this is basically a challenge parkour map that is relatively new, just came out recently. And normally it's meant to be played with a two-player race type of scenario. And then you play, and then whoever has the least amount of shards, or deaths, time, whatever, is the winner. And we're going to be doing it a little bit differently. And basically, I'm going to be running this through myself, and then I'm going to challenge you, the viewers, and see what your score comes out to be after I do it my first round. There's also more parkour, parkour 1, 2, and 3, and there's also three dropper maps over there. So without further ado, we're going to see how this thing works. And as the countdown goes, I am going to press my timer on my thing and get going. There's no time, just run. Oh, that's seriously it. Okay, so when I say go, we're going to start this thing, and I'm going to have my timer right here to record my time. If you want to check it, you could record it throughout the video. And yes, so ready? 3, 2, 1, let's get this thing going. Oh, the frames have just dropped. The frames have just dropped with the start of this parkour. So I'm not the greatest at parkour, but I can assure you I'm not the worst. And, yeah, okay, I was going to say, like, if you die, can you even... Okay, now it starts out on the lower one. Alright, oh man, messed up! I'm going to try to get the lowest score I possibly can, and see how you guys fare to a little challenge, if you guys want to go. I'll take your word for it if you post it down in the comments, but, you know, it'd be better if you record it, so then there's viable evidence of you beating the score. Also, challenge any other YouTubers out there who want to take this challenge, also play it with another player, and start, like, a little trend viewing here for Jay Minecraft. Oh, that sucks. That just sucks. We're at about a minute already. And this is a long parkour map. I flew through it earlier. Just to check how long it is, and it is a while long. Oh man, I've had it twice now. But yeah, there's a lot of different colors and color schemes to go through, so it's not necessarily easy. It's not hard parkour, but it's the simple jumps that are going to screw you up. And I hate four block jumps, so that's why this is a pain in my butt. Ugh, come on, you can do this. I can get all the way to the end without a problem, but then once we get to that last four-block jump, that's where the problem begins. I'm just trying to keep up some momentum so I could fly through that four-block jump without a problem. But as of now, we're not looking so hot. Ah, Jesus. Get through. So maybe after this, go check out the other parkours that have buttons to take you there from. Come on. There we go, finally. Go check out the other parkours when we're done, the droppers and stuff. This whole thing, the whole land, has like the scheme of stained glass. So I'm assuming that the other parkours and the droppers, I didn't go in and check any of those yet. I'm assuming those have something to do with stained glass as well. Just a feeling. Because apparently the Jay Minecraft has a thing with stained glass in Minecraft. Oh, Jesus, it's getting harder. Time is looking at about 2.5 minutes. I don't really have a judge because this map is relatively new. I haven't seen any other playthroughs of it. There wasn't even any comments in the discussion thread, so I don't remember when it came out. But I'm recording this on the 10th of January, so base that in comparison. There we go. Pink blocks. Boink, 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 boink. Come on. You're doing good. Ah, oh, we lost the train. The four-block jumps are the things that screw you up. They're the hardest of them all, I think. Or three blocks and one up. Hey, my yellow. I really do gotta change my skin back. Eh, just hang over. Oh, no. Come on. to keep a train of speed going just to keep up the momentum. And I realized that there's going to be people who are just going to completely demolish my score. But it's all about getting into the groove, and right now, the groove is not with me. Not doing terrible, though. I'm only going to do it one run through, so there's people who are going to probably like try this like 50 to 60 times just to beat someone's score, whether it's my score or someone else's score on YouTube who has like the lowest of score, and try to beat that. Oh no, not these. Couldn't make the last one, the 4 block. Couldn't make that 4 block either. At least 3 or 4s, I can't even tell. Look like they're all 4s. Maybe some of them are 3s. I'm not sure. That one, this one is the middle, it's a 4. Why is it so difficult? It's not difficult at all. Why is it so difficult? It's like the jump at the very end of the block. And we're gonna run off. Come on. Come on. Jeez. I just completely jumbled it up. That was bad. Mistimed. Ah, man. Had about 5 minutes into it already. Ugh, it's not going good. Almost at the end, too. It's not like we're far off here. The end's like right up here. Come on! How am I missing that jump? Anger is building within me. I don't know what to do. Oh, Jesus. Come on, goddammit. Come on. Yes, yes. And stop the clock. 5 minutes and 35 seconds is my time. So if you guys would like to go and challenge that time, the time will be down in the description below. If you want to challenge it, the map link will also be down in the description below. If you want to come and try out. So 5:35 is my time. So let's go over here and check out parkour number one. Oh. There's the... I think we're missing the floor. So, I mean, this one is basically you fall and you're... Oh, there's a tree. Oh, those are the other two parkours I'm missing. This is technically a dropper, too, but, you know, the unbeatable dropper. No! Oh, there... That's me. Oh, there's one shard. So this one will basically be challenged upon how many shards it takes. So I will also have these down in the description. So this will tell you how many. This one's not time based at all. This one's just shards. So how many deaths it takes to get through all three, not just this one. That was stupid of mine. How many shards does it take to get through all three of these? So it doesn't matter which one you do first, but whoever has the least amount of shards is what you're going for. Alright. It's still all the stained glass. Actually, the wall is regular glass, so it's not all stained. Okay, got one done. I have 2 shards in the board. One done. So the second one. This one has trees. Oh, this one, you gotta go this way to start. Oh boy. Oh, that's a longer jump. That's 3 and up 1. I can do this. Curious to see what kind of scores are gonna come in. Like, legit scores are gonna come in from this. Ah. Oh, that's weird how the glass just turns all black when you look up at the moon. Weird. You're up here, like the moon is like dead above, and once you fall, it like just changes. Now, how do I wanna? You have to go to this one. I didn't even jump that time. That's great. That's just fantastic. Ah, squeaky noise. Up that. Just fall off the block. Parkour. Minecraft. trying to get that timing right. I don't know if I'm going for the right angle at either, though. Ah, Jesus. Does that one do? Can I take the jump from here? Nope. Not gonna work. Already at 9 shards. Ooh, almost went flying by. There we go. Get that one. And then this one. This one here. Good. This one's over here. Oh, jeez, this is a long one. Oh! I was almost there, too. Dang it. It was right there. It's not really that hard now that I know what I'm doing. Ah, Jesus, now I just say that. See, don't make it far enough. It's weird how some of them is like that little bit of timing, that one like little like pixel of timing can affect your entire jump. Oh, that was close to landing on like the very last pixel. That's fine. Oh, I just fell off the tree. Just fell off the tree. And knocked out my Wi-Fi at the same time by punching the desk. There goes the Wi-Fi. Oh, it doesn't affect. Scan to a computer is no longer activated. It doesn't matter. I'm playing this single player. It doesn't really affect my game at all. This is a long run. Is that possible? Is this possible? That's not possible. This one is, though. Oh, there we go. There we go. Where's the button? Where's the button? Oh, it's up there. Okay, got that one done. The 12 shards in the clock. Alright, now the last one. Oh my lord. This is gonna be a pain. Pains. Literally a pain of glass. Don't wanna overjump. They're tough to find the edge of the block. This is the only reason this is more difficult than the other ones. A bit less of an area to target. Oh, especially these. Ah, Jesus. Especially those. It's like harder to target the area that you can hit versus the area that you can't. They're not like terribly hard, but it's just you can easily mess up. Trying to get your bearings about where the area of the block is. Okay. That one's tough. That's going to be tough to get the angle. It's like fence parkour. You have to get like this weird jumping angle to get through it. God, that one just fell off the block. And I have 15 shards. I hate when that happens. You just go a little bit like too far and doesn't let you tip the jump. And then that one just apparently you don't even get there. I wish like people didn't just make like a hole in the floor. Maybe like a pit where it has like the tripwire, and then once you activate the tripwire it just instantly kills you. So you have to fall all the way down there and take like a ton of ticks until you're dead. Just time management, I don't know. Ah, oh, that's gonna be impossible. I'm gonna struggle with that one. Honestly, if it does get like overwhelmingly like frustrating, I could just just keep recording. Fast forward mode. I can't get it. I just can't get the distance. There's a pain getting back there every time, too. I'm sure it's like a checkpoint. Nothing to say about this. Just angry. Anger. Did that twice in a row now. Why? It's like I'm holding control. Why do I fall off the back of the block? Why are these things black? It makes me... I'm wondering if that jump over there with the pain, if I can stretch my reaches and like control myself. I don't, man, I'm getting tired of this. If I get up to 30 shards and I don't, if I don't win, I'm gonna concede. I'm gonna concede the challenge, accept my defeat, and have you guys go in here and probably like do it in like 3 tries. Like, where is the extent? Right here's the extent of the block. Right there. Oh, thank you. Oh, no, there's more. It's not over yet. It's not over yet. It's not over yet. Oh, my God. Are you really? 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 This is, like, seriously. This is so ridiculously hard. 24 is my total. Thank the Lord I didn't follow that second part. That would have been a pain. So 24 is my total through the parkour. So that's another challenge for you to beat. Now let's go to the dropper. Oh my God. Right, so take 24 off. Ow. Take 24 off. And we'll begin with this. Oh my God, holy crap! Like, what in the world? This is like ridiculous. The amount of blocks that I have seen going down that path. And the lag. Or my computer's like spazzing out. She's like, no. You've died enough. I didn't take damage on that one. I got lucky. Ow. I'm wondering if you could like propel yourself to one of the sides. Nope. Like, I don't know even what I'm supposed to be hitting at the bottom either. Ah, so close. I think it's all webbed down there, maybe. Tuck and roll. Ow. There's a water puddle in the middle, so it's not that easy. Technically, you can kind of grab this and go. You can only get so far though before like you're really taking heavy damage to the point where, yeah, so you can only get down so far doing that. You can't make it all the way. I didn't even hit that block. I would have had it that time. Ow. It's like, you have to, you can't go, like, directly out to the edges. If you find your way out too far, I mean, you're gonna die. Is that jump? No, it's not makeable. I'm trying to find the way, the easiest way to get down this thing. I know it's supposed to be a dropper, but I am dropping. I don't know if this is the most legit way to do it, but... make the drop. Oh, that's still like, holy crap. It's like you almost have to do it this way. There's so much that's down there. That's it. Yeah, this guy. Man, this is difficult. Ow. It's really difficult. It's one of the harder dropper maps I've seen. Oh, that's half a heart. Let's take this route right here. Nope, that's death. I'm wondering if there is a way you can maneuver yourself in here to find your way down to the bottom. There's gotta be like one block you can find your way to that lets you just fly right down. It's like you could probably get to the corners, but at the same time, is it gonna do you any good? Because you have to get back, like, sort of to the middle. Like, oh my god. I don't know if you even have enough time to get back to the middle if you can take a corner. Like, honestly, it's... this is, like, really hard. Take this. Okay, now we're gonna take our our time on this one. See if we can get this one. Just trying to maneuver this because. It's like, just blech. With how difficult this is. This is difficult. I'll give the credit to this. This is a hard one. And there's gonna be someone that's gonna like fly right through it. And be done. I don't know if this is if it's meant to be done this way, but I'm assuming it's not. But I've been given the opportunity to finish it this way. I still can't even see the ground. I'm down this far and I can't see the ground. Oh, there it is. There's the water. So there's a way to do it. Alright, so let's go to the second one. That took a lot of deaths. Oh, I didn't expect that. So this one is basically find the gaps. That is, like, trippy as. Like, oh my god. Look at the trippiness. What in the world? There was one block I had to get through. That's a one block gap. Are you really? It hurts your eyes. I'm trying to find, like, the white. Finding the white in each hole. I'm trying to angle myself to where I can ski through that one and then pull it back. You have to pull it back and then get in that corner. I was staring down the wind. I was literally staring at it. Oh, I'm backwards on this one. I'm trying to get my, like, which way do I have to aim to do this? Yeah, this is better. Nope, I was already too far to the right. But you have to clip it. You have to clip the... was it the fourth one? Yeah. The fourth one you have to like keep like really tight. And then pull it back. I mean, you can go out, I guess. Go out in the fourth one and then start pulling it back in just to get some momentum coming back across. Ah, man, I can't do it anymore. That part was normally pretty easy for me. These are not easy droppers. You're gonna come test this for yourself. You're gonna find out these are not easy at all. Come on, pull back. Ah, I can't pull it back fast enough. Oh, oh. Not too far. I hit the second one. Man, it's so difficult. It's like he doesn't... I'm not, like, pulling enough speed back. Get the zone. It doesn't matter if like if you catch this first one, because then I mean your only benefit is you could start from that one instead of like direct. Instead of from straight down. You could start down a little bit further and actually might even help. It did help. Well, alright, let's get to the final part of this, which is the third dropper map. Let's see what we got. And we got trees. We got lots of trees. It's a significant amount of trees. Alright, let's see if we can... Yep. Oh, that was clutch. So, 24 off of that. Take 20 off, get down to 64. So 61 deaths it took me to get through those. So that was awful. But I will have all of the achievements down below if you guys want to come check this map out for yourself and try to beat my challenges. If you enjoyed, remember to hit that like button. It'd be greatly appreciated. Comment down below whether maps you want to see me play, other things you want me to do, games, whatever. And subscribe if you're new to the channel, or if you haven't subscribed already, it would be greatly appreciated if you would. And also down in the description, you're going to see some benefits. You have the Jinx benefit, which you can go on and get some sweet deals on gamer gear. You get the Loot Crate benefit, you can get some money off for signing up for Loot Crate. And you also have my clothing store, which has some discounts on it for some Dilemma King apparel. So thanks for watching, guys. Hopefully you all enjoyed, and I will see all of you guys in the next episode.
Are you coming back to my life? I thought